I'm not remotely concerned by what the ambassador said. He was doing his job properly, and for the most part I agreed with his comments. I think a much more serious matter, not for the Americans, but for the United Kingdom, is who in either Whitehall or in the British Embassy in Washington was responsible for handing these documents over to the newspapers. Because if the reports are correct, these are various memos and telegrams dating back to 2017. The United States is our closest ally. That's been the situation for very, very many years. And from time to time, what Americans say about the Brits or what Brits say about Americans gets into the public domain, and it's not always complimentary. So that's entirely fair. We've had the same problem with the Americans occasionally. Today, they're having it with us. The whole job of an ambassador is to give a candid view to his government back home, in this case in London, about in this case the White House and President Trump. If the ambassador wasn't making the remarks that genuinely reflect his views, then he wouldn't be doing his job properly. That's what he's paid to do. So there's nothing that the ambassador said about President Trump that hasn't been said with far more vitriol and far more impact by many American senators, congressmen, some of whom are in the Republican Party. So I don't think Mr. Trump is known for his sensitivity to personal criticism. I mean, he doesn't like it. He sometimes reacts against it. So we might get the odd tweet. If we're very lucky, we'll get a tweet.